The gentlemen, go back to your corner and let's get ready to dance, baby.
Every referee likes to get in a little bit of a phrase. Let's get ready to dance, all right? This guy's got the shoes on. Here comes trouble. Here comes trouble via a significant reach advantage. And Fred Kassi, what does he take out of that areola fight into this one?
The fact that he made it through there, got a draw, didn't lose, coming off a knockout loss, that does a lot for a fighter's confidence, especially when he's coming in against another heavyweight knockout artist in Brazil.
No easy road in boxing to begin with, but if you don't have connections, it's an even longer road. So Fred Kassi has that. And a big reach to deal with.
One of the things that worked in Fred Cassie's favor against Areola is his awkward style. He's a southpaw, but he switches back from southpaw to orthodox really seamlessly. As he's moving, he stops and he's a southpaw. He fires from there. He resets, he moves as an orthodox, fires from there. And for a fighter trying to gauge his timing, gauge his distance, set up his shots, that's very offsetting. It's hard to do.
Had some good conversations with our good buddy Daniel Jacobs on this very factor a couple weeks ago, with Daniel switches in the middle of fights. And then we were looking at some guys who they're average on each side and trying to talk about what you buy into. What you going to trust in your opponent, or do you just go with your own style?
I think you just have to stick to your guns, stick to your flow, and really start reading your opponent, what he's doing from bow stance, so you have an answer when the opportunity presents itself.
Now, ideally, you like to catch a guy in the middle of the switch, but if he's doing it from far out, he won't get there. And then you see what Cassie's trying to do. Switch from far out and then lunge in from an angle.
Well, this is where catching Kassi from far out is where Brazil's 11-inch reach advantage comes into play, because Brazil really, he switches range, he switches stance while he's almost, he's not quite all the way out of range. You look at him right there, he's moving just a half step outside of the distance of Dominic Breazeale. If Breazeale can time that switch and step in with it, he's got a great shot to clip him and make him pay for doing it.
And Kassi is bold himself. He slips the jab and lands a left hook, so he shows some feistiness.
He snapped back the head of Breazeale.
And you have to have the courage to attack a guy bigger than you and try to find a place where you're comfortable launching a counter.
That's
what a lot of guys can't do, but we've seen Fred Kassi doing some of that in round one.
Take a look back at some highlights from the first round. And here we see Breazeale trying to go to town, establish that jab early. Kassi just kind of flicking away, trying to keep him at bay. And here's Kassi closing the distance. He throws a jab cross, steps in with the cross, so he's in the southpaw stance, and then shoots that left hand, and it snaps back the head of Dominic Breazeale. That was the best punch landed of that round, Davey.
He's a righty, comes a lefty in the middle of an exchange. That's good.
That is good, but on those, he has to watch out, because a short little hook with that switch step coming will make him pay for that.
Second round action, Dominic Breazeale, Fred Kassi, Dave Bontempo, and Joey Varner with you on Premier Boxing Champions from Birmingham, Alabama. Breazeale 15-0 with 14 knockouts. Kassi 18-3-1.
Go back up. Brazil's punching, pumping that jab, but he's really got nothing behind it. He's really not putting a lot of pop on it. It's almost a feeler jab right now. And if he wants to take advantage of that range, I think he needs to put some steam on that. Start peppering, nice body shot.
Right,
peppering that jab. You know, push off that back foot, put some snap on it, and try to snap back Kassi's head with that jab. That's going to establish your distance. It's also going to make Kassi second guess coming in with those bull rushes.
And do I trust it after a while if I'm getting hit? There's a good body shot by Brazeale. He got Cassie's attention with that one. Good right hand. Kassi says, come on in for more. And he gets the crowd up by fighting back. So in a difficult moment, Kassi stayed true to his style, and that was a tough moment to test his composure.
And he landed, I think aside from that body shot that Brazeale landed, he landed a nice solid shot in there himself. Brazeale's best punches so far, we're early into the fight, but so far it's been the body shots. He's landed three or four solid hooks to the body. Kassi.
Good counters here. But if you're Kassi, the timing has to be exquisite. You're trying to duck one and then come in. I think that uppercut you're talking about for Brazeale is going to be there.
One thing I'd like to see Brazeale do is sit down a little more. He's really upright. He's fighting a shorter man. Sit down a little more so you're punching right at the chin, not at the forehead.
And some guys have difficulty punching down at opponents even though they have the reach advantage.
And that's where you lower your stance.
So Kassi has some excitement at the end of round two.
Brazeale backed up. Kassi leaps in with some punches. It's the uppercut on the inside that snaps back the head of Brazeale. Another look, Brazeale covering up as Kassi firing back against the ropes, but he's firing. And he's the one who's landing the better headshots in this fight so far.
Some of Brazeale's better moments coming here, his body work. Third round heavyweight action, our theme for the evening. Dominic Breazeale and Fred Kassi. Breazeale on the right of your screen. Now, what do you think about between rounds standing as opposed to the stool?
Some guys like to do it. You know, some guys don't need the rest. I think they also think it gives them a mental advantage over their opponent. Their opponent looks over. They're on the stool sucking wind. They see their opponent standing up, looking fresh. You know, they think they believe it could be discouraging to their opponent. But speaking of the corner, you know, when Brazeale first got to the corner, the first thing his corner told him was, you're too tall, you're too upright. We were touching on that as the second round came to an end. He needs to sit down a little bit more, start firing that jab with some authority from a distance, but not from so tall.
So he has to lean in, crouch a little bit, movement at the knees.
Not necessarily lean, crouch. Just sit down. Just bend those knees, sit that butt down. Get so you're firing, you know, not down, but straight.
To get down and then fire straight.
There you go.
What they want.
Go, 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 go.
And a guy has to abandon his comfort zone a little bit to do that. If he's used to a certain way and if he gets away with fighting tall.
And that's something, though, that should have been worked on in camp. You know who your opponent is. You know who you're fighting. You know your height and their height. You know your height advantage, your reach advantage.
Come on, come on.
You know, you should have made that adjustment with your sparring partners leading up to this fight.
Breazeale trying to walk Kassi down, then misses with two, and then there's a tie-up.
You know, it's funny, in the first two rounds, Breazeale landed about four solid body shots, but he really hasn't gone back to the body since then. That's been his best punch. Cassie's best punch has been to the head, which is another funny thing is how are the judges scoring this? It's Kassi who's landing the harder punches upstairs, Breazeale downstairs.
And this was the judicial dilemma we found in El Paso.
Yeah.
With Kassi and Areola. Areola looked to be the aggressive guy, and Kassi countering and sneaking and getting in some shots that couldn't be ignored. Breazeale trying to find positioning, and he eats a couple of shots. After the bell, that was blatant on Kassi. Lucky it's only a warning.
And here we see the end of the round. And there was the bell sounded, and Kassi, he didn't like Brazil's last punch, which came at the bell. So he decided to throw one of his own.
Listen to me and listen for the bell here. I got him.
Left uppercut. Right hook, left uppercut. All right? And the ball's on the inside. That's the cheek, elbows down. When you're in the inside, open up that stance a little bit and bend your knee so you have leverage. You're not pushing it over, keeping it off balance.
We start round four. Dominic Breazeale and Fred Kassi hooked up in it's chess where Kassi is concerned, trying to play angles in the countering realm. And Breazeale trying to throw power. He just hit him with an elbow. Cassie's counter.
Kassi is clearly the quicker of the two fighters. He's getting off first. He's avoiding the punches of Breazeale. He's landed the better shots, I believe, this fight.
Breazeale trying to corner him and get into range. And right there, he should have went to work.
You know what? Breazeale is a guy who likes to set his combos up. He works his way in behind not a stiff jab. He kind of feels it. He sets it up. He touches. He tries to find his rhythm, tries to find his distance, really tries to set up the perfect combinations before he fires. But the thing is, he's got a quicker guy on his hands than Fred Kassi. So while he's trying to set up this perfect combination, Cassie's getting off first with quicker, more solid punches.
Breazeale has to slow Kassi down. Didn't nail him.
Looks like Breazeale chopped him on the back of the head with the punch, the bottom of his glove.
Looping right hook by Kassi, who then goes into the right-handed stance. And Breazeale tried that uppercut, then the left hook got in. And now he starts to load up. Breazeale sensing an opportunity, and he nails Kassi. And this is the power mode that Breazeale needs.
We saw this in the Consuegra fight. Breazeale didn't open up until he had been rocked, until his head has been snapped back, until Consuegra had landed some solid shots. It seems like in this case that it might be the same thing. He needs to get hit. He needs to realize he's in a fight. for him to really open up with some bad intentions.
Get a little angry, and for him, maybe be less technical and just more adrenaline oriented. I mean, you want to study the angles, you want to be in the right position, but some guys don't transition into their anger too well off that.
Another thing for Breazeale is he tends to jam himself. We'll talk more about that next round.
As round four comes to a close in a good matchup here.
Breazeale mad opening up the best work he's done this fight, pinning Fred Kassi in the corner, opening up a barrage of punches, nothing landing clearly, but you can see the bad intentions on the punches. He's throwing with ferocity, he's throwing with a purpose, and there's the nice overhand left hand from Kassi, lands flush. That's the one that really got Breazeale riled up. As you see him unloaded, he landed a big hard right hand.
Fifth round underway. Dominic Breazeale, Fred Kassi in Birmingham, Alabama. Dave Bontempo and Joey Varner with you on Premier Boxing Champions. Deontay Wilder will
work out of there. Work out
follow
of there.
This one. Here comes Kassi, swarming, mosquito-like.
Well, right as the two fighters came out, Kassi landed a big right hand. I mean, it was flush, and he just went on the offense from there, backing up Breazeale into the corner. And his style's awkward, man. It's really rough for anyone to deal with. You see the way he just kind of loops those punches, then grabs and punches, and switching from orthodox to southpaw, just a hard puzzle to solve.
And a courageous fighter, because he's in with guys stronger than him. So you have to go toward the power first to get inside of it. Most people, you know, when the other guy's a harder puncher, you might go back. He goes toward the power.
Yeah, and the most surprising thing about that is his last two opponents, Breazeale and Areola, are big punchers. They're knockout artists. And in his fight before that, Kassi was knocked out.
So it all would make sense that he would be in survival mode and try to be cute and play on some angles, but he's also realized that he has to be inside to try those angles. So he's willing to pay the price.
You know, we talked about this in the Areola fight. Kassi was supposed to be, I don't want to say a stepping stone, but he was a rebound fight for Areola. Because Areola, let's get you back in there, let's get one in the win column. Here's a guy who's coming off a knockout loss, doesn't have the most impressive record, doesn't have a lot of knockouts. And I think Kassi came in that fight with a chip on his shoulder. And I wouldn't be surprised if he did it again tonight. He's thinking, you guys think you're feeding me to someone, but I'm the one who's eating tonight.
So give me my props.
Stop. Back it up.
That will be another discussion, whether you can get a decision in situations in which you're the counterpuncher. And here comes Breazeale finding some room. Now, you talked about him jamming himself in the last round. What kind of adjustments is he going to find to make here?
You know, for me, I believe it all starts with that jab, and I think Brazil's using his jab all wrong. It's a pawing jab. He's trying to paw and walk his way into distance. And when he finally does walk his way into distance, he's overcommitted. Instead of using it to find range, to establish distance, and once you touch with that jab, don't close the distance further behind that. Once you find that range, touch with that jab, let that combination go.
How do you feel, man?
here we look at some of the action from the previous round. Right there, it looks like a clash of heads. But Kassi just bull rushing Breazeale to the ropes, almost knocking the cameraman off the cage. Excuse me, off the apron. You see the cameraman gives the thumbs up as Kassi continues working.
With six coming up.
Cameraman had to worry about that three knockdown rule.
Seconds out.
And they worked it on the inside. Sixth round action, Dominic Breazeale, Fred Kassi in the heavyweights. Not the classic heavyweight barn burner shootout. Kassi trying to counter and play on angles, and Breazeale, who's 15-0 with 14 knockouts, trying to walk him down.
Dave, you might call me crazy, but I wouldn't be surprised to see if Kassi had won all five rounds.
Well, it's going to be real interesting as we move along, and I don't think it's crazy. Depends on what a judge is favoring. And the counterpunchers have an uphill battle to start with because they have fewer opportunities. But if they excel in that area, you can overcome that.
And I'm not looking at offense, you know, or counter. I'm not looking at who's coming forward, who's counterpunching, you know. I'm looking at who's landed and consistently landing the more damaging blows at a higher frequency, and it's hands down Fred Kassi. There, right there, you saw that it was a little one, but he's, you know, you see Brazil's head getting snapped back. Aside from that body work, I haven't seen Cassie's head being snapped back too many times from the punches of Dominic Breazeale.
I'm going to say that maybe we're in the neighborhood of a one-pointer halfway through. So I think somewhere in that realm is where these judges are. And what are they favoring? Because usually it's effective aggression. But if they see aggression and it's not quite effective, now you're in that debate with the counterpuncher.
Remember, the number one criteria, though, is damage done, right?
Damage done, clean, effective punching.
So if you know, you've got the aggressor not doing damage, the counterpuncher landing the significant shots, doing the majority of the damage. Again, though, you just never know what the judges are saying.
And here's Breazeale trying to close distance. He saw a little bit of slowness in Kassi, so he tried to jump on it. If Kassi does slow down, then he's in trouble, because that would take away that countering mechanism for him. Double jab here by Breazeale, but a pouring jab. Left hook by Breazeale.
Gentlemen, 10 seconds.
Not a whole lot landed in this round. Both guys looking a little tired. 7th underway. Dominic Breazeale, Fred Kassi. Dave Bontempo and Joey Varner with you on We're Boxing Champions. Birmingham, Alabama. Kassi's nickname could be the chameleon.
Yeah, or the frustrator.
And normally you see a guy like this, you say, okay, double jab and then hit him with an uppercut. That will stop him from going into his switching realm. Hasn't worked out that easily for Breazeale, but it did just rip him with a left hook to the bottom. And a sneaky uppercut came from the smaller fighter.
That's a very interesting thing about this fight is those sneaky uppercuts, you think would be the majority of them would be landed by Breazeale, but it's really Kassi who's been sneaking those in there.
The little guy with the uppercut. There's the good hook by Breazeale. Right hand by Breazeale gets in. Remember, he's got significant height and reach. Sneaky right hook by Kassi. And then back to a righty.
Nice right again, follow it up.
What about the angle if you're Breazeale believing this guy's not that big a puncher? Go for it, even if you take something on the way in to get him out of his rhythm for the privilege of throwing your power.
Well, he might not be a big a puncher in regards of KOs in the knockout column, but he's landed some solid shots. I think those shots have done enough to warrant the respect of Breazeale, to halt him from you know, selling out, as they say, and going for broke.
It's an important angle to consider. Bigger guy with the knockout record. Has to respect Kassi. Does jab and lands a right hand and gets out.
Ho, 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 ho. No back in, brother. Come on, come on, come on. Let's go. Let's go. 10 seconds, all right?
Warning about the backhand swat on Breazeale as we come to the end of round 7.
Time!
Some of that action. Big right hook lands from Breazeale. Excuse me, from Kassi. Breazeale answers. There's the hook. Breazeale answers with the right. Kassi does a great job of pulling out of range just in time. But that was a nice right hook. There's another look at it. Breazeale going first with that uppercut missing. And Kassi, that right hook has been his go-to punch for this fight.
Round 8 upon us with Dominic Breazeale and Fred Kassi. Heavyweights. Kassi trying to be a stylist, shifting back and forth.
Neutral corner, give me time.
And this is a mouthpiece issue.
Come on, man. Bye. You to the neutral corner. Give me time in.
Now the referee gave him some slack there. Let the mouthpiece come back in. That's
what
the corner can't allow to happen. And Breazeale following up by attacking.
Such a weird jab from Fred Kassi. He flicks that southpaw jab and almost pulls back as he does it. Almost as like he's anticipating a counter from Breazeale and he wants Breazeale to run it. It's almost a defensive, offensive jab.
So to fight effectively, if you're Kassi, you need enough power from either side. And you're probably not going to be a big puncher anyway. Otherwise, why would you go to the other side?
Right. What he's done, he's found a style that works for him, that he can make effective.
And here's the way to take that away if you're Breazeale. Go to that body, and then you slow him.
And I don't know why Breazeale hasn't been doing that for the last 5 rounds. You know, we talked in the first 2 rounds, he landed some nice solid shots. He really pulled off those. This round we're seeing him invest into the body again, opening up, ripping some nasty body shots. But where have they been the last 4 rounds?
If you're Breazeale and if you can land these body shots, and you take that Baryshnikov factor away from Kassi, the dancing, as the referee said. Hey, if now the guy's not dancing, he's laboring and his movements aren't trusted. And here comes Breazeale sensing an opportunity.
Those body shots will do another thing for Breazeale. They'll open up those uppercuts right up the middle, which is one of Brazil's best punches. You see another backhand from Breazeale. It's the second time the ref warned him. The second time he's done it, the second time he's been warned. That is a frustration move.
Yep, I can't punch on the angles I want. I can't set myself when I want. So, one of Brazil's best rounds.
10 seconds, boys.
Even as the crowd not appreciating it as much, he got some good work in on the inside.
See that jab of Kassi landing and Breazeale opening up, throwing a combination upstairs, jab, cross hook, uppercut, but nothing cleanly landing. Kassi doing a great job of just slightly moving enough to avoid the full force of the impact of the punch.
Come on, come on.
As we start round 9, good question when you look at those replays is, on the second reflection, you see that a good number were blocked and some got in. Judges don't have the benefit of that replay angle that we just showed you. So nice. What do they see?
I think they just saw Kassi cracking Breazeale with the jab cross.
And that was easy enough.
And then an overhand land from Kassi. And one thing to take note of, you know, I told you my scorecard. I think I've given Breazeale 2 rounds, maybe 3. The rest I have Kassi clearly winning. But if you listen to the corner of Dominic Breazeale in between rounds,
you think he's the heavyweight champion.
No, they heard the call for urgency. They said, show him what you can do. First it was, what are you doing? You got to show him what you can do. The whole world's watching. Show the world what you can do. This is where the heavyweight championship starts. That's not a, you're winning this fight. That's not a, you're dominating this fight. That's a call to action. That's a sense of urgency from his corner.
Well, they should have some. Good right hand by Breazeale. But they didn't tell him you need these last 2 rounds either. So they're somewhere they should have been more specific with him.
You know what? I think that's walking the line of motivating your fighter and giving him confidence and not breaking him down.
Looping shot by Kassi.
Yeah.
comes Kassi. I think it's going to be very interesting watching these scorecards, because this is a classic example of a counterpuncher making a bid. And how do judges reward the counterpuncher? Will be interesting if we get all the way through this. As Breazeale.
Well, just over 3.5 minutes to go.
Breazeale lands a hook. Good right hand by Breazeale.
All right, stop. Stop. Come on, stop. All right, come on.
And the jab.
10 seconds, gentlemen, 10 seconds.
And a good right hand by Breazeale. Some of that action from the last round.
And there you see Breazeale opening up. The best punch again he landed was that body shot. Kassi slipping, the jab doesn't land, the cross doesn't, that body shot does. And there's that overcommitment. You see how he leaped in, and when he was in range for that uppercut, he was just overcommitted, his distance was off. And there's Kassi slipping that jab, landing a jab cross of his own. And it might not be that the punches of Kassi are so powerful, but they're snapping back the head of Dominic Breazeale. That says a lot, that's telling.
If they're sharp, they can be 5 on a scale of 10.
Exactly.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together as we now go to the 10th and final round. Touch him up, there we go, come out.
Dominic Breazeale and Fred Kassi get a good round of applause as they start the final round of their 10 round heavyweight contest, as they top off this fight and set up evening. Deontay Wilder, the proud heavyweight champion, the Alabama native, defend his heavyweight championship on his home turf after this. Good hook by Kassi, has a right hander, and a good jab gets in. Breazeale found a guy that gave him some work, but he's had trouble finding him.
So he didn't quite find a guy that gave him some work.
When you put it together, no, he hasn't. And he's been blitzing through everybody. Has 1 8-round victory, so he is in brand new territory. Breazeale has not been past the 8, so he got through 9.
Work.
And now he's in the 10th, so
stop.
Both of these are first time appearances by Breazeale.
Breazeale just hasn't been able to find those big punches. His uppercuts, his straight shots, they've just been missing their mark. He found a successful tool, an efficient weapon in his body shots, but he's just been going to the too few and far between.
Well, we've seen almost nothing in the uppercut department for Breazeale, and that's a built-in edge for him.
You know what, he's thrown them. He's just hasn't been able to land them. As he lands a great straight right.
Good left hook here by Breazeale.
One of the reasons he hasn't been landing that uppercut is because he's been jamming himself on the inside. When he punches his way in, by the time he gets an uppercut range, he takes one step too far, and he's got Kassi's chest or head against his chest. Is Breazeale hurt?
He's tired. Let's go. Kassi can't
10 seconds, boys.
Comes out of the crowd. Well, it's in the hands of the judges, and it's going to be fascinating now. Breazeale, the guy on the way up, had some good rounds at the end. Kassi countering. Is it aggression? Is it counterpunching? What did the judges see in this fight? If you're Fred Kassi, you're saying, what more could I have done?
I think if you're Fred Kassi, you're saying, I won this fight.
Good right hand there by Breazeale.
That was his best right hand of the fight.
There's Kassi trying to walk him back and then sag against him. This is the first 10 for Breazeale, showing a little fatigue at that spot.
And you know what? Cassie's head movement was really good tonight. He did a phenomenal job right there. He's getting just out of the way of every punch thrown.
And then gets his own in.
Dave, I gave this fight to Kassi, 97-93.
All right, let's see. He fought his heart out.
If you're going off of damage done, who landed the better punches with higher frequency, I thought that's Fred Kassi 100%.
Dominant.
Now it's
Kassi had a good stretch of rounds, 3 through 7. Breazeale was real good in 8, 9, and 10. They both want to get this nod. And they both think it's close enough.
Gentlemen, it's a good fight.
Do a little lobbying.
I love the lobbying post fights by fighters, but it doesn't make any difference now, but they all do it.
That's the body English.
Yeah.
When you see a guy lifted off the canvas by his corners, they're praying at that point.
Yeah. Every little thing helps.
Middle round's good for Kassi. Momentum at the end with Breazeale. Breazeale was stalking. Kassi was countering.
Who do you think got it? I hate to put you on the spot, but
I'm going to put you on the spot. I think Breazeale had the 8, 9, 10, and one of the other rounds very close. So I could see this being a one-pointer or a draw.
So you gave him 8, 9, 10, three
Two,
rounds?
One, maybe one in the beginning, and then one was very close in the middle.
Gave him 9 and 10 and one in the middle. I thought 1 and 2 Kassi took. Again, like you said, though, it's being the counterpuncher, it's hard to steal a fight.
It's going to be interesting to see how they looked at it, if they give Kassi credit for the countering, because then you're into the ring generalship category, which he did show a lot of in this fight.
But I keep on going back to this, and I don't know if it's going to make a difference. The number one criteria is damage done. And in that case, I think in the majority of the rounds, Fred Kassi was landing the harder punches and doing more damage than Dominic Breazeale.
He's hoping the decision goes
for
him.
Ladies and gentlemen, having gone the distance, we'll go to your judges' scorecards at ringside. Judge David Hudson sees the fight 97-93. Judge Erwin Deutsch sees it 98-92. And Judge John Westerterp sees the fight 100-90. All for the winner by unanimous decision. Dominic, here comes trouble.
That's a horrible decision.
Breazeale.
You hear the crowd booing.